Hello YouTube, welcome to today's updated tutorial on how to customize your very own Warzone custom health bar 2.0. Warzone decided to update itself, moving a couple things around, and so I'm making an updated video on how to use this template. I've seen a lot of big Twitch streamers and YouTube streamers have these on their streams whenever they're playing games like Apex, Warzone, and I decided to make a template that is free to everybody and they could download it, customize it, export it, and use it on their stream. And I'll also be making follow-up videos on my TikTok to talk about things that may not have been mentioned in this video. The needed programs for this tutorial will be After Effects and WinRAR. I will have the download links in the description for both of them. Now, before we do that, I would love to give a huge shout out to today's sponsor of this video, Own.TV. It's your one-stop shop for all your stream aesthetic needs, from overlays to panels to alerts. They have a super cool emote maker that you can create unique emotes for your Twitch or YouTube or Discord. They also have a really cool system using modular designs to where you and your friends can all pick up the same design and look completely different. It's such a smart idea and such a great opportunity to create custom looking graphics for super cheap. Feel free to jump over to Own.TV and pick something up, and make sure you use the link in the description below that will support the channel. And also use my code for a huge discount at checkout. Now to start out, you're going to hit the link in the description, which will bring you to this Warzone custom banner 2.0. This is a Google Drive link, and all you have to do is head up to this download all button and it will zip up your file. After downloading, head to that file wherever it downloaded to, right click and hit extract to Warzone custom banner. This is a very important step from all the other videos. If you do not do this and you just open it up and try to open up the After Effects link by double clicking on this and then going into it, video files won't link up and you're just gonna have to restart. We're going to double click on this folder that it just made and go inside of these folders until you see this page. We're gonna head inside of the footage tab first to download this font. It's called Primetime. How you download it is by right clicking and hitting install for all users. It will look like this. It'll come up and it will install. After that, you can go back into the previous folder and double click on Warzone. Once the template opens up, you will be met with a pop-up that says to resolve fonts. Just click OK. We're not using any of those fonts. And then this is the page that you are met with as soon as you open up the template. Now it looks very complicated, but really it's not. We're gonna walk through it together. To start off, if you go up to Effect Controls Control Layer, this is going to be your main color palette for the entire banner. If you don't see this window, head up to Window and then come all the way down here to Effect Controls Control Layer. Click on that and it should pop up. And here you can see we can change different items like the color of the text. We can also change the extrusion of the text itself. We can change the glow. Now, really the glow, you can kind of see it on the screen, but more than likely you can't. You might as well just change it to the same color of your text. You can also change the background and then the border of the background. As you can see, we have full control of all of the colors inside of the template. I also added something new on this one. You can add in, if you want, some outline bars for your health and then your money and then your shields, of course. I've noticed that it sometimes looks good with some colors and it sometimes doesn't. So I gave you the option, and here's how you do it. You click this little eyeball on the bars outline tab down here. So you have your control layer and then you have your bars outline. You can toggle it on and off. Next, let's talk about switching this name from sample to your channel. To start off, you're going to click on replace text here. And as you can see, scrolling through the timeline, we have full control of the text itself. It's kind of hard to see. So to make a black background appear, you're going to go down here on toggle transparency grid, click it. And now we can see our text. To change the text listed here, you're going to double click. That'll highlight the whole thing. And while we're here, let's go over something that I completely forgot to talk about in the last tutorial, how to change your font. I gave you guys a font, but if you guys don't want to use this font, you want to use your own, here's how. With all of the text selected here, you're going to come over to this character tab, click the drop down, and now you have options to the fonts that are listed on your computer. If you don't see this character window, we're going to do the same thing where we go up to the window tab, scroll down until you see character, click it, and it should pop up. One specific thing that I did not go over in the last video was how to download new fonts in case you don't like any of the fonts that are on your computer or the ones that I have given for you. So in order to do that, here's where you're going to go. On Google, you're going to type in DaFont, click enter. You'll click on the first link that you see called DaFont Download Fonts. And here are a bunch of fonts that you can use. It's not just these four. These are just the recently added. Here are all of the options that you have the type of genres that you can choose from. My favorite is sans serif. You can find some very cool title based fonts. When you find the font, you can hit download on the font and then install it anywhere you want. And what you'll do is you'll do the exact same thing that we did when we first opened up our template. So you'll right click, extract to made Tommy or whatever your font's called, double click on it. And then as you can see, this has a boatload of fonts. So I'll highlight all of them and then install for all users. Looks like I already have this on my device. I thought I didn't, but whatever. And there you go. Now back inside of After Effects, inside of the replace text here tab, you can highlight all and then go over and type in the name of your font, which mine was called Made Tommy. And then there you go. Now it's updated. You can click back over to the Render Me tab and there's your new font. Another thing that I really like about this template is that you can go back and forth from this replace text here tab to the Render Me tab and it updates live. So you get to see as everything happens. Now in this case, let's say that you want to make the text a little bit bigger. So you're going to come over here and inside of text, you're going to make sure that this selection tool is selected. You're going to click it and then grab one of these corners here and just yank it. Now you can see that we're not holding any ratio. We're going to hold shift and that will keep the ratio. Once you have a look that you like, you can head back over to the Render Me tab. Of course, that's a little big. It's cutting out of the box a tiny bit. There is a hidden box that kind of like keeps everything in order. So make sure that you're in that box. Finally, we get something that I'm really liking. All the text comes in. We get that little fade. It kind of sticks out of the box, which I kind of like. And that's how you replace your text. Now, if you guys have any problems with this, please let me know and I will be commenting back and more than likely creating TikTok videos for this that will be short 30-second ones to fix whatever problems that you guys are having. Last thing to go over is replacing your logo, which of course is right along the bottom inside of replace logo here. You're going to click on this tab. And as you can see, your logo fits in the very bottom corner of our look here that we have. And so when you guys import your logo, which we're going to go over in a second, it's more than likely going to pop up here in the center of the screen. So just be aware of that. Your logo's not missing. It's in the center of the screen. In order to upload your logo, you're going to head over inside of this project tab. This is kind of the bank of all the assets used inside of the template. You're going to right click in here and then click import and then file. Scroll through, find your logo. You can upload it by just double clicking on it. It'll pop up inside of the project tab and we're just going to drag it in over top of our main logo. My logo is white, can't really see it. So of course we're going to click the toggle transparency grid. Now to drag it over, all you're going to do is make sure that it is selected down here. Just make sure that it's not accidentally sample logo. You're going to make sure that this is selected. You can come over and drag one of these corners. We're going to do the same thing that we did with the text by holding shift. It'll keep the ratio and we'll get it to the size that we want. And then we're going to move it down to the bottom. In order to turn off the sample logo, we'll go down here and click the eye on the sample logo tab. And now we have our logo set in place. Of course, you can go back to the Render Me tab and see it switched live. I'm not getting the full logo in here, nor am I getting the right parts of the logo. So we'll do a little bit more experimenting. You can also, to get closer to your logo, as you can see, we're zoomed out very far and you guys may be more zoomed in, but to mess around with this, you can click this drop down right here and this will make the preview window larger. If you're just looking at a black screen because it zooms into the center, you're going to hold down space and this will bring a hand up and you can move your preview window around. Now that we have the logo in a good looking place, let's head back over to the Render Me tab. It's looking a bit better. We can go back and forth and mess around with it. And I am liking the look of that, other than the fact that it says sample, but you know, hey, this is just for the tutorial. So as you guys are finishing the customization process, now it's time to head into the rendering process. So let's make sure that you are in the Render Me tab. And then we're going to go up here, click on composition and then add to render queue. Down at the bottom, you should see a difference. Now we are in the render queue tab. We're going to double click on lossless. This will help us change our version and the format of our video. We're going to change it from an AVI file to a QuickTime file. And then we're going to hit RGB plus alpha. I have noticed that some people like to render things out inside of Media Encoder. It'll work the exact same. Just make sure that you have QuickTime selected and then you select animation. This is all looking good. Now we're going to click OK. The last thing to do before we hit the render button is we're going to specify what folder to output it to. I'm just going to output it to my desktop and then we're going to click render. Once it's done rendering, now it's time to get it onto your stream. If you are an OBS or a Slobs user, first let me go over with you guys how to do it. You can see that I'm in OBS right here. Inside of your sources for your Warzone gaming display, whatever scene you have for Warzone, make sure you're in that scene. Inside of sources, you're going to right click, add, and then add a media source. Once you name it whatever you want, it's going to open this window. You're going to head on over to where it says browse, go through and find your render. Double click on your render and then make sure you hit loop and we should be good. You can hit OK. Now our banner is on our stream. It's already cut in a 1920 by 1080 ratio, ready for you to use. You can start up Warzone right now, throw it as a game capture underneath this banner. Now, if you are a Stream Elements user, let me show you how to convert this into a Webm file. Now pause for those using Stream Elements. Last tutorial, I told you guys how to change an MOV file to a Webm file using a website. Now, a lot of people have reached out saying the website did not work and or it had a lot of problems. And recently I've been seeing a lot of problems with it. I wanted to add in this portion of a tutorial on how to download Shutter Encoder, which is a very free and useful tool to convert your overlay to a Webm file. I'm going to leave a download link down below in case you want to change it to Webm, and we can walk through that. So the link in the description should take you to this website. Where we're going to go is hit downloads up at the top, and then you'll download the version that you need. This will open up a PayPal window to donate to them. You don't have to do that. You can install this wherever you want. Once it's downloaded, open up that installer file and it should download the program. So this is what Shutter Encoder will look like after you've installed it. What we're going to do first is browse for that file that we just exported. Once it's uploaded inside of Shutter Encoder, we're going to choose a function. And this is going to be an output codec of VP9. VP9 is just a web player that's super easy to play on Google Chrome, Microsoft Edge, and other things like OBS. After that, we're going to go to advanced features off to the right, and then we're going to enable that alpha channel. That way it has a transparent background. So after enabling the alpha channel, what we're going to do is we're going to make this file even smaller for Stream Elements because there is a file limit of 30 megabytes. If you are just putting this into OBS, you don't have to do these extra two steps, but it is worth it to do so. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn off the audio by clicking the audio settings and then clicking on this drop down. It should be like this option right here. We're going to click no audio. Then we're going to go up to the top here and we're going to change the 5000 bit rates to 23366. And the file size should go to around 13. And we're going to just lock that in by hitting this lock right here. And then you'll start the function. This should go straight into the folder that your other render that we did in After Effects goes to. It doesn't ask you to choose a different place just because it goes to that exact folder. After the process is completed to 100%, you can close out of this guy, and now you have a Webm file of your Fortnite custom health bar. Now you guys are ready to upload to OBS. So I'm gonna put you in the void for a second here so I can show you this. Inside of your gaming or your Fortnite specific scene, we're going to click this plus arrow and then we're going to add a media source. We'll call this the Fortnite banner. So here we're going to browse and find our render. One of these is the MOV file and the other one is the Webm file. So you can see if I hover over the sizes here, you can see the difference. It's a 1.2 gigabyte versus a 43 megabyte file. And so it's really going to save your computer if you're going to use the Webm file. I will show you both though. So we'll add this MOV file. Make sure that you hit this loop button and then go down and hit OK. So you can see we have our banner inside of our OBS scene. Very soon I will be coming out with a DaVinci Resolve template that you can use and download that will easily create the exact same thing, but for completely free. So if you guys are looking for any Warzone, Apex, Splitgate, Fortnite, any of these newer games that are coming out even, I will be making lower thirds, banners, and a bunch of things for them for you guys and your stream. That way you can be all branded up. One more thing, streaming DMCA safe is my playlist that I have created and I've had ever since I started streaming, stopped streaming, and now here we are. The playlist has grown to almost 10,000 followers, and it is a one press and go for a full 80 hours. So it will run your course for any subathon that you're doing or any small stream that you're doing. You'll always be listening to different music. No more having to switch playlists, switch music. It's all in one spot. Thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.